Hi, my name is Mitch, and I've been eating the produce from this particular stand for a long time. Zaid and Haifa, they produce the best vegetables you could ever have. And here's one of my favorites. It's called husk cherry. And you take it, you peel it, and you can eat this. I mean, I
organic ginger.
You get a basket of these, little, and I sit and I watch a movie. I eat these like it's popcorn. The ginger is, I take this thing and I slice it really thin. And if you have a steady hand, you can just do it with a knife. But if need be, you use a mandolin, as they call it. I think it's a mandolin. You just thin slices. You wash it first, of course. Then thin slice it. Put it in vinegar with a little bit of honey. And you can put salt in that. I don't use salt because it's not good for your blood pressure. And I keep it in the refrigerator, and I use it like a condiment. And it'll keep in the refrigerator. I have some in there for a year. I mean, this is ginger, and not only that, but it's so good for you. Ginger is so healthy. I mean, you can't beat it. These pumpkins, the best. I mean, I eat the whole thing because it's organic. I wash it, and then I take a piece of it, and when I cut it open, I get the seeds. I take the seeds, I dry them. You know, dry them out, because they're good for your prostate. They're good for your health generally, all right? Every man should eat plenty of pumpkin seed, and any woman who wants an active man should definitely feed him pumpkin seeds. And his watermelon, this is one of the last of the watermelons. The cabbage, ah. I mean, you want to taste something? It's got taste. It's got period. Just taste. All right? These cabbages. Oh. And the nice thing is, no spray, no pesticides. It's healthy. It's just plain healthy. And corn, you never tasted corn like this. This is so... Oh. So sweet, and I only steam it like maybe a minute. That's all. You don't want to ruin the corn. You put a little water in. You don't fill the thing up with, you know, like a tub. You put a little. You cover it. It comes to a boil. You steam it for a minute. You turn it off. Take it out. You can eat it without butter or anything else. Just plain. It's great. And by the way, these are sugar peas. These are great shelling peas. I take those shelling peas, and you can eat them raw, but I take them and I put them in a little container, and I shell them in there. I put them in the refrigerator. So when I cook beans and rice or something like that, I add some of the peas. You put a little butter on that sweet butter. Wow, I mean, talk about it. And another thing, these flat beans, these are my favorite. These flat beans are just the best in the world. I mean, and you just steam them too, and they're crunchy. And boy, are they great. I take the potatoes, and I, aside from getting regular size, this size, I get these little ones, and I put them in an iron skillet. I wash them, put them in an iron skillet, and roast them. Just low flame. Leave it there. And then when they're ready, you just take the thing, let it cool down, pop it in your mouth. You don't even butter it. I put a little pepper in it. And they're just delicious. Oh, they're great. I mean, especially these little ones here, like that. They're like popcorn. Well, a zucchini is just delicious. There it is. The zucchini, I slice it. Or sometimes I just take the whole thing, wash it, put it in the pot, and just let it steam. And that's it. Because all the flavor stays in here because I haven't cut it. And then when I cut it and eat it, whoa. I mean, I do the same thing with string beans and with as many things as possible. And the tomatoes, this tomato, whoa. I mean, they taste like tomatoes. People often say, tomatoes, you get them in the store, they have no flavor. His tomatoes are just fantastic. You take one of these, you brush it off. Delicious. And all of his tomatoes have flavor. All of them. I've never tasted a tomato here that didn't have great flavor. I mean, and sometimes I take the whole tomato, wash it, put it in a pot with a little bit of water, and I let it cook until it's really... By the way, the seeds in the tomato are very good. It's lycopene. Very good for your eyes, your eyesight, and your general health. I take it and I steam it, you know, until it's very, very tender. Then I crush it. Then I put some oregano in there, and I put a little bit of black pepper, and then I put turmeric. The turmeric is activated by the black pepper. Very, very good. Very healthy for you. And I put sometimes garlic in there, crush the garlic, and I have tomato sauce. It's very simple. Or you can put vegetables in that. And that's it. I mean, just... You can't go wrong eating the vegetables here. They got flavor. From the start. I used to own a restaurant a long time ago. And so I know what, you know, cooking good food, it has to start with good produce. Anything. Anything you start with, something's good, not poisonous. And organic, absolutely convinced, is the only way to go. And this is the end of the season, and it's not, I mean, it's an extended summer, and the produce that's coming out of here is just extraordinary. I mean, extraordinary. And I hope this summer, I hope it goes on a little bit more, because then we have fresh produce every week, and it's just, you can't beat it. And by the way, when you're cooking beets, a lot of people throw the tops away. I don't. I wash them, and then I saute them, squeeze some lemon on it, or put a little touch of apple cider vinegar, and just a touch of butter. And it's just, you can't beat it. Adios. Have fun and good eating. You can't go wrong coming here.